Prince Philip, Duke of Edinburgh, dead at 99. This is the Railway North Report. All right, so everyone knows that Prince Philip, the Duke of Edinburgh, died, and he's the husband of Queen Elizabeth. If you don't know that, then you're not too bright, but what can we do? Now, what does this have to do with Canada? Other than the fact that he's the consort of our titular head of state, not much. He has been to Canada on multiple occasions, both on his own and with the Queen. And he's been pretty much well-loved and well-respected through most circles. You know, in his lifetime, he's made more than 20 trips to Canada. Some of them solo, starting in 1951. Did a 20-day visit to various Canadian cities back in 54. Six-week tour of all provinces and territories. So it's not like the Queen and Prince Philip have ever not cared about Canada or toured Canada. You can see all their little trips. And in recent memory, 2002, 11-day visit to Canada. 2005, 9-day tour of Saskatchewan, Alberta. 2010, 9-day trip to Canada. And then 2013, Prince Philip made a solo 2-day visit to Toronto, where he's presented with the highest rank of the Order of Canada, new regimental colors to the 3rd Battalion of the Royal Canadian Regiment. So he has been important to Canada in that sense, as a visitor and a distinguished visitor. He's done a lot to promote the Navy and the Canadian Armed Forces, and his naval ties made him very much a welcome visitor in Nova Scotia. You know, this is a guy who he fought against the Nazis and the Japanese, both of whom were very racist at the time, and served with distinction. Trudeau issued a statement on Friday calling Philip a man of great service to others who maintained a special relationship with the Canadian Armed Forces and patron to more than 40 Canadian organizations. He took his responsibilities very seriously, and he's remembered for his great purpose and conviction, as well as his humor. Now, his humor often got him in trouble. As he put it, he often put his foot in his own mouth, which others construe as being racist. Now, my favorite Yahoo correspondent for Canada, Elisabetta Bianchini, she writes that Prince Philip's death condolences for royal laced with stories of racist and offensive comments over the years. Elizabeth must make her living on social justice warrior routines. But she goes through the first part of the story, talking about how people see him. And Trudeau, who I'm no fan of, said that Prince Philip was a great purpose and conviction. He was motivated by a sense of duty. Prince Philip was a spokesman for not just the British royal family in the UK, but also for the Commonwealth. Dedicated philanthropist and decorated naval officer. How do you feel about discussion about Prince Philip's legacy? So of course, they have gaffes and racist comments cloud legacy. They have a little discussion here. He should be honored for his service, 48%. We can honor while discussing his gaffes, 27%. I don't believe he's very honorable, 18%. I don't know how I feel, 7%. So I don't know. I don't believe he was very honorable, 18%. Okay, those must be the Nazis online. Many people, the social justice warrior crowd, like to talk about his past racist, sexist, discriminatory comments. They've been reported as gaffes throughout his lifetime. And they got a couple of his most highlighted ones. And then you got all the social justice crowd on their Twitter accounts. Thank God I'm not on Twitter. I'd feel my IQ dropping every minute if I did that. Now, looking at all these people on Twitter, because Elizabeth always puts these Twitter things on. She doesn't go and get every facet of society and how they feel. She always gets the worst. I'm telling these people right now, what are you guys, holier than thou? Your shit don't stink? You float above the rest of us? None of you guys have ever said a racist thing in your life? This guy was in the public eye for so many years. Of course he's gonna say some things that are considered racist and taken out of context or without shades of gray. You don't go through decades of life under a microscope and not say something. Why don't we start examining Mr. Phil Jimenez? Start examining your life and see how many racist things you've said in your life. Or Christian Christensen, whitewashing racism. Okay. If you've been to Asia or the Middle East or anywhere else, see how racist they are? So those haters out there, a bunch of little people who are jealous of somebody who actually won the golden lottery, happened to be born in the right place, married a princess, became her consort, never became the king. Couldn't even give his last name to his kids unless they declined the royal title. As a proud Canadian, I'll always remember Prince Philip as a war hero, decorated naval officer, and someone who tried to keep the Commonwealth more or less together. Because the Commonwealth could become more than it is today. If you think about it, the Commonwealth could become a huge trade zone, and we should be binding ties with all our member nations closer. But anyway, that's just me. All the Canadians out there, let me know how you guys feel about Prince Philip. Whether it's good or bad, it doesn't matter. Just remember that not everyone is perfect. And leave your comments below, hit the like button, subscribe. Until next time, this has been the Railway North Report.